everybody's soul is not one. The mind is one. The fundamental tendencies of mind are one. Same greed, fear, temptation, violence, that is what the mind is. The same three-dimensional universe that we all perceive, that is what the mind is. That is one. The truth does not belong to anybody. The truth is neither diverse nor one. So to use an expression like everybody's soul is absurd in reference to the truth. You can say everybody's mind. Yes, of course. Just as you are an object, the mind is an object. So you can say, just as you say, you know, my book, you can say my mind. But to say everybody's soul in context of the truth is to burden language to express something that it cannot express. You don't have the truth inside you when you say everybody's soul or my soul. Your intention is to say that you have a soul which represents the truth. No, you, as you are just mind. Originating from the truth, but declaring itself to be separate and distanced from the truth. So when you are talking of human salvation, you are actually talking of salvation from humans. When you are talking of your liberation, you are just talking of liberation from yourself, which is your mind. The mind's own self-concept that it is something, that it is separated, distanced. Unfortunately, that happens to be the definition of existence itself. You call anything as existent only when it is seen or expressible as a separate unit. If something is identical with the other thing, then it will not carry a name. And if something is identical with the other, which is identical with the next, then nothing will carry a name and nothing would be expressible. As far as that thing that if one is liberated, all should be liberated. Yes, indeed, that just happens. But it does not happen in the way you presume it to happen. When one is liberated, all are liberated, because when one is liberated, one is liberated from allness. When one is liberated, then you come to see that that which we call as diversity, differences, allness, is in itself so superficial. All the differences that we see arise from the tendency of the mind. So the differences need not be talked about. Whenever we are talking of differences, we can simply say, oh, it's the tendency of the mind. So allness in that sense is gone. And even the tendency of the mind need not be talked about, because you come to see that the tendency is prone to dissolving. The tendency itself suffers and wants to go away. That the tendency is not something that expresses itself even when you are deeply relaxed in sleep, then how can this tendency be real? So allness keeps going. All the things, objects, people that you usually perceive, they start losing the significance that they hold, the seriousness and the consequent fear that you attach to them. That starts receding. That is the meaning of salvation. Till the time you are seeing different people as different, different situations as different colors as different, then you are not liberated. That is what it means.